This next song, you know, I said that it's really important for us to be here tonight, and that's true, and it's not just because this is what we do for a living and we're so happy to be back doing it. I also believe that music has a very important role to play in the world in general right now. I think it's no secret that we're living in some very difficult, turbulent times, and music is one of the things that I think allows us to stay connected to some sense of joy of being alive, and allows us to take on the many challenges that we're facing right now. Yeah. And I also feel like music is very important for communities. Live music and venues like this one are very important because there are so many forces that are conspiring to tear us apart from each other and to divide us from each other. And I think music is one of those things that allows people to get together in a real physical space and not see each other as a political party or an opinion about this or that, but as fellow human beings sharing this very basic human need and human experience. And that's kind of what this next song is about.
Just let me.
Thank you so much. This is Will Bryant on the keys. And I have got to say something about this gentleman here on guitar. This is Jim Boja, who is an incredibly talented musician and actually has stepped in at the last minute to save our show because our usual guy was diagnosed with COVID and couldn't get on the plane. So Jim has stepped up and is playing this show.
Thank you.
So, as I said, we have a new record that just came out last year, and it's a record of all new original songs, and it's a very personal record for me, and this one song in particular I wrote for my daughter. I have a teenage daughter who is beautiful and smart and funny and creative and warm and loving to everyone but me. And I want so much, you know, as she's standing on the precipice of adulthood, I want so much to give her this hard-won advice and these words of wisdom to save her time, and she really just doesn't want to hear any of it. Yeah, it's a shame, right? She kind of thinks I don't know what I'm talking about. But with what I do for a living, I can take those words and I can put them in a song, and maybe someday she will listen to it. I did try to play it for her in the car once, and she was like, "Mom, this is so awkward. I really don't want to hear this right now. It's just too awkward." So, as far as I know, she's never listened to it, but maybe she will someday. And until then, it's there for anyone else who might need it or want it. And, you know, in all seriousness, what I see is that despite the fact we've come so far in supporting our girls and our young women, they still seem to have internalized this feeling that everyone has to like them, and no one can be mad at them, and they have to do everything perfectly, and they have to look a certain way, and they have to act a certain way, and the whole social media thing is so toxic, and I feel like that leaves them open to being manipulated by people who do not have their best interests at heart. And that's where the song comes from.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is a song, excuse me, from the Relish album, which some of you may know. Thank you. And this is a song that we kind of took out of the rotation for a long time. You know, you get new material and you put some of the older ones aside. And we didn't play this song for a good 15 years. But right before the pandemic, a gentleman reached out to me on social media and said that he was coming to our show that night and just flat out begged to hear the song. So we pulled it out of mothballs and gave it a new arrangement, and we're going to play that for you right now. I got it for these guys up here. Come on.
Yeah. Thank you. things like heaven, and in Jesus and the saints, and all the prophets, and God is great, God is good, what if God was one of us, just a slob like one of us, just a stranger on the bus, trying to make his way home, just trying to make his way home, back up to heaven all alone, like a holy rolling stone, just trying to make his way.
For being here with us tonight. We've got another song to do for you, and this is a Bob Dylan song, but it's actually not on our Songs of Bob Dylan album. This is a live only bonus track for you who have showed up to be with us.
Stage, money and drugs at your command, women.
Sleeping in a king-size bed, gonna have to serve somebody. Happy birthday!
Bill's birthday is tomorrow, actually, isn't it? Is it midnight already?
Not quite.
Happy early birthday to Will Bryant. Yes. Here's another song from the new record.
Give it like a gift of nature's.
be here with you guys tonight. Thank you again so much for coming. I'm supposed to say that we do have, my British Airways lost my luggage, so I don't have a whole lot of things to sell out there, but what I do have, I would be happy to come out and sign them for you after the show if you'd like to pick up a copy of any of the CDs that we have. And thanks again for the amazing opening act. I'm sorry, I'm totally blanking on her name now. Is it April?
Alice.
I got the first letter right. Alice. She's a beautiful, beautiful singer. Thanks to her very much for opening the show. And I, mostly what I want to say is I am very much aware that being able to do music for your livelihood is a rare privilege. And I know that the only reason I can still be out here doing this after all these decades is because I have fans like you guys who come to the shows and who support the music. And I just want you to know that we do not take that for granted. And every time we come out, we try to give 110%. We try to always be bringing you something new and fresh. And I just want you to know that you are very much appreciated. And thank you very much for being here tonight. And I hope we can continue to see you in the future.
Sure.